Welcome, everyone, to our online worship service. We're so glad you could join us today.
We are. I know it's not conventional, the way that we're meeting, but we're excited that we're able to do this, thankful for technology that we have today.
That's right. Yeah, and so we're glad that you clicked in and that you're here, and we hope that you will feel the Spirit of God move, even though we aren't together, you know, face to face. Yeah, that's right. But we are glad that you're here nonetheless. And it's going to be a great time just to be reminded of God's promises to us, and we hope that you will be blessed by it. Lieutenant Carrie McCall is going to take a moment and open us up in prayer.
Thanks, Majors. Once again, welcome and thank you for joining us for our service. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your promises that no matter where we are, that you promise to be with us, that you promise to give us peace in times of anxiety, that you promise to calm our hearts, Lord. We just thank you for that. Lord, I just ask that your hand of protection would be on our people, Lord, that you would watch over them and that you would bring them comfort, that you would bring them healing, that you would protect them from illness, Lord. I just ask that you would also be with the ones who have anxious hearts right now, that you would come and that you would bring them peace, Lord, that you would remind them daily of your presence, Lord, that they would find new ways to connect with you and to connect with others so that we are sharing your peace and your comfort with all those who are not able to be with us right now. Lord, we just thank you once again that you promise to be with us and that you promise that you will never leave us or forsake us. We thank you for that. Lord, we just ask that you would bless this time of worship, Lord, that you would speak to us, that you would calm all the anxious thoughts in our heads, and that you would speak directly to our hearts, Lord, and bring us comfort from your word. Lord, we thank you for that. We thank you for your word, and we thank you for your promises. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now join us in singing Stand Up by Transmission.
Bless the Lord, he is worthy, he is worthy, he is worthy.
As we continue in worship this morning, I invite you to join me as we read God's word. We're going to read Psalms, the third chapter, verses 4 through 6, and I ask that you follow along. Psalms, the third chapter, verses 4 through 6, and it says this: To the Lord I cry aloud, and he answers me from his holy hill. I lie down and I sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear the tens of thousands drawn up against me on every side. Major Matt's going to come now and bring our Bible message for us this morning.
Thank you, Major Rebecca. Yes, we are in some difficult times right now, but I'm grateful that we can gather together through technology, through our computers and our smartphones, and we're here to be able to connect in a virtual way. Is it ideal? No. I'd rather see you, some of you, face to face and to be able to talk with you. But unfortunately, at this moment, this is where we're at. Nonetheless, we're still going to see what God says to us and how we are encouraged and how the Lord wants us to stand firm. You know, it can be very daunting when you walk into a grocery store and see shelves empty. You know, here in America, we're used to seeing shelves full all the time. And when you walk in, they're empty because people have gone crazy and bought up everything they can. When you, there may be some uncertainty that you're feeling now because the economy is taking a hit with us having to social distance and work, putting in measures into place where people don't come in, or restaurants having to adjust their hours or close. There's many things happening that give all of us a sense of uncertainty, you know, and it can be very overwhelming. It can be, especially if you're a person who likes to be in control and like to, you know, have your safety nets. But when those are gone, we can feel out of control and we begin to feel overwhelmed and worried. As believers, as children of God, we have to be reminded about who we are. And even though we take precautions and we want to make sure everybody's safe, we still have to remember that we are God's children. I want us to look at some scripture that will help us remember about what we're up against, because who knows what the next few days and weeks are going to look like. But we do know, as children of God, we have hope. We have a future. We know who holds us in the palm of his hand. We want to look at 2 Chronicles chapter 20, because we're going to look at the nation of Israel. They had uncertainty because they were having to go into battle against nations who were much stronger than them, usually had much more advanced armies that were bigger than them. And they were having to go against a group of people who were very, very intimidating. And it's almost unfair in the numbers in which they had to go against them. But the words in which are shared serve as a good reminder for us today, because what happens outside of here, you know, we don't see this virus. We don't see the impending doom. We know it's there, but we can't see it coming at us. So it's almost unfair. We don't have a way to avoid it. We've put measures into place that have affected our families, of trying to distance ourselves, make sure we're washing and being extra vigilant. Schools are out, all these things to help hopefully control the spread of this virus, but we can't see it. We can't take precautions based on what we can see. So it's almost like we just feel out of control, and that gives us a sense of anxiety and worry, or it can. But as children of God, we have to understand that the enemy or the problem or whatever it is that we may be up against is much, even though it's bigger than us or maybe outside of our control, we are not at a disadvantage. We have someone on our side. We have the Lord God himself. And the words that are spoken in 2 Chronicles chapter 20 from Jehazel, who is a member of the Israelite army, and he stands up and he says these words in verse 15 of chapter 20. And he says this: Listen, King Jehoshaphat, and all who live in Judah and Jerusalem, this is what the Lord says to you, and he says it to you and me today. Do not be afraid or discouraged. Are any of you afraid or discouraged? I bet some of you are. Because of this vast army, or we could put in that phrase, because of this virus or this time of uncertainty, whatever fear you may have, you could put right there in the place of vast army. For the battle is not yours, but God's. This battle that we're up against, it's not ours. we're not in this alone. You and I aren't intended to go against this uncertainty and these problems. No matter if it's a virus or anything else that's going on in our life, you and I aren't intended as his children to go up, to think that we are in it alone, to go against it alone. This is God's battle, not yours. And he wants us to give him permission to give those worries, those problems over to him, because they're his and they're his to fight. That's what he invites us to do. And this is what Jehazel was saying to all the Israelites, and including the king. Listen, this is the Lord's battle. This is his. That's what he invites you and I to do. And then King Jehoshaphat goes on to say in verse 17, and this is the next point I want to make, that first of all, the battle's not ours. And when we acknowledge that, this is what God says to us. Verse 17 of chapter 20, you will not have to fight this battle. Isn't that encouraging? You're not going to have to expend amount of energy, and you shouldn't have to expend a large amount of energy in worrying, trying to fight off and figuring out what to do. You will not have to fight this battle, he says. Take up your positions. Now, what is our position? Our position should be, first of all, on our knees in prayer, praying, asking God for guidance and wisdom. Our position is to have a place and a mindset that we are, first of all, our faith is in him, but we are his hands and feet. Our position is to show love to people who are around us, who we come in contact with, who are worried and overwhelmed. We are the picture of Jesus to them. We're him to those people. You and I have to fight this battle. Take up your positions. Stand firm. I think about football. Sports is always a great analogy, but the football where the offensive linemen who are standing there and they're standing firm to keep those people from the other team from pushing in on the quarterback. They stand firm. They dig in their heels. Listen, we got to stand firm. This is no time to retreat and run off thinking that this is unfair. I don't know what to do. This is the time we stand firm as his children. Stand firm. Stand up. Speak truth where it needs to be spoken. Share his love with those who need to hear it and see it. I encourage you to do that, but we need to stand firm. He goes on to say, do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. Go out and face them tomorrow. But here's the wonderful part. We can face this virus head on, do what we need to do, protect ourselves, use common sense, but we don't have to be afraid because the final words of this says, and the Lord will be with you. I think that's our biggest fear in all of this, that we're in this alone. It's all on my shoulders or your shoulders, but we're not. We have the Lord God, the creator of heaven and earth, on our side. And he invites us to trust him, to give him our problems. Isn't that great? And to rely on him. We have to remember that he's going to deliver us. My wife read the scripture from Psalms chapter 3, and it tells us that he is going to sustain us through these difficult times. He's the one that carries us through. And maybe you need that right now, to be reminded that it's not in your strength. It is not your battle. It is God's battle, and he's going to deliver us if we trust him to see us through. God will sustain you, Psalms chapter 3 tells us. My wife read it, as I said, and it's to help us remember that he will sustain us. He holds us in the palm of his hand. Do you believe that? He holds us in the palm of his hand. That brings me great comfort in this midst of uncertainty and this craziness and just the things that are going on. My hope and trust come from knowing that I'm in his hands. No matter what happens, I know and I trust that I'm in his hands. And I'm here to tell you that today. You are in his hands. If you trust him and give him your problems and understand who he is, that he is on our side. That's a great comfort and a great thought. You know, I've had friends of mine who were much bigger than me, who were you know, stout and had much bigger muscles. And I always took great comfort subconsciously in knowing that when I went out and they were with me, someone messed with us, I knew that I was not going to be harmed because they were much bigger and could take on any adversary. Yeah, I could have helped too, but I know that just that comfort of knowing that presence of someone who's much bigger and stronger out watching over me and knowing that I'm protected. I think of that as how the Lord is. He has us in the palm of his hand, And he is very strong, and he can overcome because he has overcome the terrible things that surround us and can overcome us if we try to tackle them on our own. I invite you during this time, as a song plays in just a moment, to remember and meditate and think on the words that are sung, that we are in his hands. And if you are feeling overwhelmed with anxiety or worry or fear, be reminded in these words that are sung. And I hope that you will take from this time today that we are in his hands. God, no matter what the future holds, we know that we're in your hands. And we ask right now, Lord, that you will just help us to understand that. Lord, make it real in our hearts and minds. May this fear that some of us hold, this worry that we carry, the anxiety that weighs us down, Father God, Lord, we pray that you will just remove it. We give it to you. No matter what tomorrow holds, we know that you hold the future and we are in the palm of your hands. So I pray for each and every one who's listening, who has clicked in, who has heard your word today, that they will be strengthened and that they will be the people who represent you in this time of uncertainty, that they will stand firm in who you are and who they are in you, that we will still fight, but not with anger and frustration, but with love and care and compassion. And we use that to fight off the enemy. Because, Lord, you've won. This battle is yours. We thank you, Lord. We give you honor and glory for all that you do. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for joining us today. And we hope that you'll click back in the coming weeks as we continue on having our services virtually. We hope that you will be blessed by this time. We are so grateful that you stopped in. May God bless you.